Enchanted Tiki Talk is brought to you by Kingdom Strollers. Our premium stroller and crib rentals are delivered straight to your Disney or Orlando area resort. It couldn't be easier. Book yours at kingdomstrollers.com. And Mouse Pros. Let our travel specialists plan your next vacation. Our concierge level service gives you the perfect hassle-free vacation. Get your free quote from Sean or any of our magical agents at mousepros.com. And Mickey Monthly, the Disney fans' monthly subscription box that brings the magic right to your door. Visit them at mickeymonthly.com. And by Woody's Sunglasses. Don't let glare ruin your magical view. These premium wood-frame polarized sunglasses will let you tour the parks in style. Visit them at woodys.com. And now, it's Cho time!
Vahidi me kyoni mana, ladies and gentlemen, no flashbulbs, please. Our performers are temperamental and easily upset. Thank you for your cooperation.
Oh, look at all the people.
My goodness, you're all staring at us. We better start the show rolling.
Wait, wait, we forgot to wake up the Glee Club.
Hey, howdy, hey, and welcome to Enchanted Tiki Talk. We are your hosts. I'm Sean.
I'm Keith.
I'm Matt.
I'm Scott.
And I'm Alan.
So grab yourself a Dole Whip or a citrus roll, pull up a chair, and enjoy the show.
This is episode 218 for the week of Christmas 2017. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas and happy holidays to everyone out there listening to us, Enchanted Tiki Talk. We hope everyone has the best holiday you possibly can, and we hope that you enjoy spending time with your families during this wonderful holiday season. So for those people who are listening today, well, the day the episode comes out, which is Christmas Eve, Merry Christmas, or Christmas morning maybe, Merry Christmas once again. So, you know, we just want to say Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy New Year, Happy Festivus, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, Happy Joy Joy, Happy everything else.
happy Joy Joy.
But it's been a year of hardship for many of us. But, you know, the one thing I just wanted to mention was that a year ago here on Christmas Eve, we... Alan Mize, one of the co-hosts, passed away, and I just wanted to mention him a little bit here, and how much thoughts we have for him, his family, his wife Blair, and his daughter Grace, who is now over a year old. So, you know, it's been a tough year with Alan being gone for all of us, but not as much as it was for his wife. But you know, I'm thankful that we had a podcast together and we continue to produce the podcast, you know, in Alan's memory to keep his love of Disney alive. But beyond that, it's a camaraderie, whatever it is. Can't say it right now. that we have through all of us. I know that we go off, you know, sometimes we argue with each other off air, a little bit maybe on air, but it's like, you know, we're brothers, so that's what it is. It's
what brothers do.
That's what they do. Yeah. It's we're a family. And Alan was certainly a big part of that, and he was the heart of the show. And you know, 1 year, I just can't believe that it's been 1 year already that Alan is gone. It's just something that, you know, getting past the 1 year mark is usually one of the hardest, and dealing with the holidays for Blair, dealing with the holidays, it's going to be hard for a long time. But, Alan, we love you wherever you are. Well, I certainly love you, and everybody else loves you too, but, you're definitely the number one Tiki Bird.
Amen to that. Yeah. I mean, I just want to piggyback a little bit on what Sean said. It's been a rough year. We had lots of laughs. We shed some tears. We still do when we think about him. He brought this energy to the show. He brought his kindness and compassion, which I sorely miss. He was always the one who kind of, if I started to go off the deep end, he was always the one to pull me back above water. So he is sorely missed, but through this show, he will live on forever. So we miss you, buddy.
You know, the one thing I'll always remember, one of the memories I have was in talking to Blair when we got together last was, Keith, when you and I were doing the Christmas show, we kept talking about how we were going to sing at the end of the episode. And with that, we weren't sure if Alan was going to participate at all. And Blair told us that he was hesitating to participate because of what she says is that he did not want to give in to Keith and I. He wanted to stay steadfast and not stoop to our silliness level. And Blair's like, why not? Just do it. Just give in and have some fun. And he did. And I remember Keith and I singing, Baby, It's Cold Outside. And then and he's just like, that's it. I'm out. I'm done. It's just one of the last, you know, memories that we have recording wise with Alan. So those are those moments, those are those funny little things that would just happen. It's just, you know.
Well, and he, like, could sing. I mean, he was a good singer, and it was like we kept on trying to pull it out of him, and we couldn't do it. Except for the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air theme.
Yeah. That was a You know, I'm glad we did. It's a lot of people. The podcast has certainly changed over the years, and more so in the last year. But it was just like things like that we would do to Alan all the time, just try to get a rise out of him and do things. But he thoroughly enjoyed singing that. It was, I held on to that recording for a while because we did that months before it was released. I think I added it to the last episode or something like that. I forget where I added it with him. But we had recorded that long ago, and I was just waiting for the perfect time to use it, and that's when it was.
Yeah, that was a funny... And it was just one of those things where the three of us were chatting, just off, like, waiting to start the show. I mean, it wasn't even, like, for the show. It was just... was him and, you know, us and our personalities, and it was a funny moment for sure.
You know, one of the biggest regrets I have is, I've said it before, but I don't know if I've ever said it on air, was not keeping the recordings to all the episodes that we had done. Because I used to record from beginning to end, and I would have recordings that were 2-3 hours long, and I just wish I had those, because I could have put out so many, like, lost episodes of Enchanted Tiki Talk, you know. That would have been, or just little conversations here and there that could have been made, could have been used at the end or whatnot.
Well, yes, but there was a lot of it that you probably couldn't have aired.
Yeah, I don't know. But
it's not all Disney and rainbows, folks.
No. But Alan, I know you're up there in that princess castle in the cloud, smiling down at everybody. But Merry Christmas to you, buddy.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas. And when you walk down the street, say hello.
Come live your dream this holiday season during the Year of a Million Dreams at the place where dreams come true. Visit DisneyParks.com.
And we are back from break here. Jingle bells, Matthew smells, Scott laid an egg, Keith's mobile broke its wheel on the way to my house in New Jersey. That's all I got.
Keith, when you wake up in the morning and you don't have a wheel on your car, it's Sean's fault.
I'll be like, that came true? What?
Yeah. If I lay an egg, then I'm really going to be worried.
All right, so this
week... I want a golden goose, Daddy.
This week on Enchanted Tiki Talk, I think this is the last episode for the year, right? Ching, 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 ching,
or maybe. Or 31. Nope.
No, okay. Next to last episode of 2017. And on this glorious Christmas morning, we are going to talk about things that we want under our Christmas tree that is Disney related. And with that, It's going to be items. First of all, we each going to have to pick an item that's under 50, one item under 50, one item under 700, one item under 500, what? And right? And one item
under 100.
Okay, 100. One under 100, one under 500, and one over 500. Correct?
Correct, yes.
Okay, sorry.
I was like, wait.
We forgot something.
Sean's
Daddy.
Changing the rules again.
And we needed to throw in tax as well. You remember that, right?
It was a weird, like number too. It's like under 700. I'm like, where did he come up with that?
Sorry,
that was weird.
Well, that's technically right. Yes, still works. Well, at least for me. But yeah, we just figured pick four items, kind of random numbers there that we would love to have on our to open up Christmas morning here in the Tiki Hut. So with that, I'm going to start with the baby of the group, and that's going to be Scott. Scott, what is your item under $50?
So this was actually a lot harder to come up with these four items than I thought it was going to be. And my under $50 item, I'm going to do the Pirates of the Caribbean, the vinyl picture disc, which is $21.98. It's one of the new records that I'd like to add to my collection.
Oh, okay, I've seen that one. And that's it, $21?
$21.98.
That seems pretty cheap for that.
Yeah. They're not bad for all those picture discs.
Wow, that's pretty good.
Because nobody wants vinyl anymore. That's why.
Yeah, probably.
I do.
You have a record player too, right, Scott?
Yeah, I'm constantly adding new ones to my records.
So. You have any Christmas albums?
I'd have to look. I might have the Muppets Christmas.
All right, so next.
He scratches on it too. He's like.
Yeah. I'm going to doubt that. Maybe his kids will, not him.
Yeah, no, there's no scratching any of mine.
All right, next we're going to go with the best looking, which of course is me.
Okay, so go ahead. Oh, I'm sorry.
Well done, sir.
All right, so under 50, I'm going to go to the 28 in Maine collection, and I'm going to go with the Hanger Bar Tea for Men, which is $37. I've heard that like the fitting on some of these can be kind of weird, but
yeah.
I do love that t-shirt. That just like totally fits that style of the 28 and Maine. I just love their stuff, but having the little airplane on there, the silhouette of the airplane in like an earth tone. I love that shirt. I wanted to pick it up and never did because I was afraid it wasn't going to fit right, but that's my choice for under 50.
Those are cool shirts. I have a couple of theirs, and I just love them. It's well made. The fabric is really nice. I mean, yeah, they're expensive. It's worth it, though. Those are nice.
So next, we're going to continue this order. We're going to go to the shortest one of the group there, and that'll be Matthew. Merry Christmas, Matthew.
Glad someone can bring up the short end of the stick there.
Ah.
Oh.
Ba-dum-cha.
All right, so I was putting this together, and this item jumped out at me actually a couple months ago. And as I was writing it down, I was like, man, I realize how old I am because I'm putting a tie down for a Christmas gift.
Whoa.
But since I work and have to wear a shirt and tie every day, I figured it'd be a little better if I could Disney-fy it a little bit. So they have a Haunted Mansion wallpaper tie. It's a black tie with purple print with the wallpaper print out of the Haunted Mansion. But it's $39.99, so that is what I am choosing for my under $50 gift.
I remember you showed us a picture of that. I don't know, I think it was like a month ago or so, whenever it was.
Yeah.
That you wanted it, yeah. That if I wore ties, I totally would wear that tie.
I'm trying to find a way not to be just an old, boring guy that works at a desk job all day, so.
Yeah.
I could see Matt just on the couch going, a can of Simon Eyes. All right.
Well, I didn't come up with anything for you yet. It's not your turn yet.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
I need to come up with something funny. Oh, okay.
Swedish
so
we'll, chef.
Yeah, we'll come to the funny look in one of the group, and that. that's Keith.
I thought Scott went already. What?
He's the baby.
Oh, okay. All right. So
get in my belly.
What?
Oh, no. Baby back. Baby back. Baby back.
That cold medicine's really kicking in, huh? this is something that we've actually have stopped and looked at a few times at the Emporium. It's the Park Icon Frodo frame. It's wooden, and it's got like the cutouts. It's an ear hat, face mountain, as a balloon, and then a castle. It's just really cool. I think it'd be fun to find like pictures with the specific cutouts. I could put that together. It is $32.99.
I don't think I've ever seen it. I don't remember seeing it. I've probably seen it, but I don't recall it.
I'll screenshot it to you. I was looking at it.
Thanks.
Sure thing, buddy. Yes, this is a radio program, folks. But...
Oh, wow, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, whoa, man.
Oh, look at the colors. Okay, Scotty boy.
All right, under $100. So for those that know me, I have quite a Disney book collection. I'm always looking to add to it. And I found a new one today that I didn't even know was out. And it's called Star Wars The Blueprints. Retails for $71.95. And it says, Star Wars The Blueprints unveils the original technical drawings of the galaxy far, far away. With more than 250 blueprints and 500 photographs, it tells the story of the talents behind this extraordinary epic. And then it has a lot more details about what's in it. But when I was looking at that, that sounds like an incredible book that I definitely want to look at adding to my collection.
Mm, very nice it is, yes.
That sounds like a good, just like a coffee table book.
Do people have coffee tables anywhere?
Of course they do.
How do you? I got rid of mine.
Say?
Where else? That's where they put the books.
On my bookshelf.
Duh. Nah. Then it's a bookshelf book. That doesn't sound right.
What are these books you talk of?
Yeah. You know, you can get it on your phone now.
That's no fun.
All right, my item. I had a harder. This is probably the one I had the hardest time with, but I ended up going with the Gaston's Tavern wall sign for $70. You know, it's just a much smaller version of the sign outside of Gaston's Tavern at the Magic Kingdom that I can hang on my wall. I thought that'd be like one of those things I would just throw in my office area. I thought it would be pretty cool, so that's why I went with that.
I want the whole collection of the signs. I want the Adventures Club one, which I don't think they make anymore because I couldn't find it.
They don't.
But when I was at Disney Springs, I saw the Tomorrowland logo one, which looked really cool. And there's also a Great Movie Ride one that always looks really cool.
Yeah, I've seen the Great Movie Ride one. That one does look good. But if that one like lit up, I'd be like all over
it. I know. It needs to be neon.
Yeah.
But all those signs are so cool.
Yes, they are.
Here's a Tiki Room one, too.
Yep.
It's cool.
Yeah.
And a Dole Whip.
Aloha. Isle, yeah.
Yep. Yeah, the Dole Whip one I would definitely take.
All right, so I guess I'll do mine now. Under $100, and I'm kind of maybe bending the rules a little bit because it depends on when I'm going to go. But I want a ticket for the Christmas party. I figure it's appropriate. It's Christmas time. I haven't been, so I want a ticket for the Christmas party, and I'm going to hijack my brother's airplane ticket and go Friday when they get down there, and then it was, I think, $99 for Friday.
Oh, wow.
Nice. Yeah, I can't believe that. I just can't spend that kind of money. Yeah, without tax.
Yes, without tax.
I just
can't. That wasn't even the most expensive. Like, I think the following week they go up to 110.
Man, right. I just don't see it. It's not. No way, it's not worth that.
I mean, you're paying more. What's a one-day ticket to get in the park?
It starts at
105 to 125 or something like that.
So you're almost paying the equivalent of a four-day park for just a couple hours.
Yep. Exactly. I couldn't do it. Well,
it's what? Let's see. You can get
in. You can get in at 4, and it usually goes to like midnight.
Right.
Midnight? Yes. So, yeah, 7 hours. But, I mean, if you buy a regular day ticket and you go in at, what, 9? They open at 9
they
and
they close at 9. That's,
but what I'm saying, if you go on a regular day, if they open at 9 and close at 9, I mean, yours 12 hours and you pay the same amount. I mean, it's kind of asinine to pay that much for half a day.
But this one you get milk and cookies.
Cookies.
And a parade. Snope. And a parade. Snope falls from the sky. Santa.
Holiday wishes.
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 Okay, you just justified. I will gladly pay $110 when
I knew you would. I knew it wouldn't take much.
If I was going by myself, I would do it, but with a family of four, no, I'm not doing it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's ridiculous.
I'm not paying for the kids to do that one. They're going to stay under two for many years.
I wish you can, like, you paid by your height. Like, but Matt, that wouldn't be fair for Mac, and Mac get, like, the child price, but...
Free.
That'd be free.
Yeah. But, like, your kids, like, it should be, like, two for the price of one.
I'd have to pay for them, and I'd get in free.
Mine, this is also something I've wanted for quite a while. It's just I haven't, pulled the trigger yet. It's the life-sized Umi Air figure. It's $55. I got lights up and flickers. It just looks really, really cool. It'd be perfect for like a fireplace mantle or someplace like that.
Well, I thought you were going to use it as a nightlight next to your bed.
I could, yeah. Good night, Lumiere.
That way when you wake up, you've got to walk around with him.
Right, yeah.
When he gets up in the middle of the night to pee. Right, that's I've seen those. Those are pretty cool.
The Cogsworth is nice, too, but I'd have to stick with Lumiere, though.
Yeah, I'd go with that one as well.
I mean, I'd like to say it surprised me that thing's $50, but it doesn't really, but, I mean, that's... And of course, you probably have to change the battery, what, every 2 weeks or something?
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's a decent size, though. I mean, it's not just, you know, like a ornament size. I mean, it's pretty... I don't know the specs on it, but it has to be at least, like, 16 inches tall, somewhere around there. Yeah. It's pretty decent size. I know, right?
If it was solid brass and had real candlesticks in it, I'd pee all over it.
That's the movie version.
Oh.
The live action film one, I think it does.
All right, let's move on up a little bit here and let's see what everybody has for under 500.
All right, so this is the one I had the hardest time and I kept switching what I wanted. And I went middle of the road for this one. I did the limited release. My inner child's coming out on this one. Limited release Disney Castle playset by Lego, which is $349.99.
We were talking about that at Sean's when I was there. It's really, really cool. Would love to build it. It's just, I was like, where do you put it?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like, it's so huge. It's like, you'd almost need a man cave or like for some kind of like a Disney room to put it in. It's like a centerpiece.
That would be like, that was like a great idea to, like, if we're all together at the same time recording an episode, putting the Lego castle together, talking about it, a topic while we're building it. That would be a great episode.
That would be fun.
It would be like a 2 week long episode.
I know. That's all right. You break it up.
See, the problem I would have with that is I would probably get like 3/4 of the way through it, and then one of my kids would want to dive bomb it with their brains.
Right.
And it's like, all right, I'm done. I'm not building this thing anymore.
So did
they start taking pieces from you?
Does the one of the what the heck are they called? The things turn into a missile silo? The turrets?
Oh, yeah.
Is Walt's head underneath of it?
Right.
Right.
Is the Castle Dream Suite apart?
All right, my next one is something that I've always wanted to get, and I almost pulled the trigger on it several years back before kids. Never have I done it. So if anybody out there wants to get me this, I would be eternally grateful for it. And that is the Walt Disney World Market House miniature by Olszewski, which is $275. I'll take any of his pieces, to be honest with you. But I just love that. I would just, anytime I'm in one of the stores that has them in there, I just stare at them and just stare and stare and stare. I'm just fascinated by it. I would just love to have it. Little mini models of Main Street. I just love it.
That's just like the Lego set. Like, I'd want the whole thing, but I need an entire room to put it all together.
Right.
But they're so cool. I mean, they're so highly detailed.
They are.
So I guess my question is, if once you got that, would you take it down and put it up for every Christmas, or would you put it up in one room and just, like, leave it there?
The problem is, like, I don't really have one room that it would fit in. That's the problem. Like,
Sean's kicking his kids out.
Keith knows
that you bunk up.
Sharon keeps the house very beachy, so it wouldn't really fit. So I would probably have to keep it on my dresser and just get up in the morning and talk to it and then go to work, get back from work and talk to her. That's probably what I'd have to do.
Good morning, Emporium.
What you cooking in confectionery today?
Yeah. Smells like Starbucks.
All right, so with my under 500, I am going to go back and do something that I have been able to do before and probably will never get to do again. But I'm going to go to the chef's table at V&A, and since I've got up to 500, I'm going to do the wine pairing, and I can go up to $400. So I'm going to sit there by myself and watch people cook and eat lots and lots and lots of food.
All by myself. That's it. You notice Matt's whole thing here is he's going to the Christmas party by himself. He's going to Victoria Alice by himself. Now, I can't wait to see what the over 500, because where is he staying by himself?
It has nothing to do with where I'm staying.
Ooh.
Castle suite, all by himself.
You know, it's crazy to think how expensive that thing is. I've actually got it. I try to keep it a secret, but thanks to my Disney Experience app, you can't really keep it any secret. I've got that booked for our 10-year anniversary, and my wife looked at me, she goes, that's too expensive. Do you know how much that is? I said, yes, I know, but you only get one 10-year anniversary, and it's, yeah, that's not cheap. Let alone when you add two people for it.
Yeah, yeah, hope you only get one. Sure.
You never know what could happen.
Because it would be funny if, like, you went to this and you got divorced, and then, you know, 10 years later, you're with another girl named Kathleen, and you go there again for your 10-year anniversary, and you get divorced the next day.
If that's the case, he's probably going to Pecos Bills on Victoria Alvarez. Already done this once, honey. We're starting slow. All right, so I will, as I look at this list, it looks like I've got a thing for lighting, but I picked Tiki Shrug Lamp that's at the Polynesian. It's a lamp with the Tiki Shrug kind of a base to it. And it hits $299. I just think it's really cool. It would look awesome, like on like a desk or like a nightstand or something. I just love that thing.
Is that the one? I'm trying to remember what that one is. That the one with he's got his hands up in the air.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. All right. That's what I thought. Yeah, that is pretty cool. I don't. Once again, that's something I'd love to have something like that, but it won't fit in my house.
Well, it's beachy.
Maybe with a different...
It's Hawaii beachy.
Yeah, it's Hawaii beachy.
Not New Jersey beachy.
Well, Sharon's is more like Cape
There's
Cod
There's no
beachy.
T-shirt shops around it.
Oh.
There's hair gel in every room for that house. It's crazy.
All right. So let's spend a... Let's see what we're gonna Santa's going to bring us for our item over 500.
So this was the first thing that came to mind for me. And it's not something that's necessarily going to fit under my tree. But wow. I guess, hey, Matt's going on a holiday Christmas party anyways. So I am doing the 10-night Norwegian Fjords and Iceland cruise from Copenhagen, Denmark to Dover, England in a deluxe ocean view stateroom with veranda, which sails August 16th, 2018 on the Disney Magic for $14,210.06.
Holy crap.
Man. Whoa, I don't even know what to say on that one. I didn't even think of that. Wow, yeah, that's...
No, that... I feel really cheap now. Like, I was...
I mean, if I'm going over 500, I'm going over 500.
Like Santa loves me. Because I didn't ask for that much.
I mean, are you building a snowman while you're there?
Yeah, I'm going to see the sky awake.
Wow.
Wow. Guess I should have looked at the Adventures by Disney website when I did this, because there's quite a few of those trips I would like to go on.
Boy, you're greedy.
It was either that or it was like a 9-night Alaska, and I was like, no, definitely want to do Norway and all that stuff.
Hmm.
Well,
it's like the first thing when we came up with this. As soon as we put the categories, I went straight to Disney Cruise Line's website and looked at all the sailings and picked that one. Before even looking at the price, I just picked which cruise I'd want to go on.
Well, I feel cheap now. I mean, for my
I know
I just wanted the DVC Platinum Annual Pass, and that was $723.14. That's all I'm asking for is a year annual pass to Disney. That would be perfect.
It's not a bad one.
Yeah, that was... I chose two things because I wasn't sure, you know, exactly how this episode would pan out. And I was, well, now I'm just going to ask for both of them. Screw it.
All right, Sean, it's all you.
That's it. That was mine. DVC annual pass. That's what I wanted.
No, I meant Keith is pulling it, Sean.
Oh, yeah. That's. I'm just good with the one. I'm not too greedy here.
Yeah. Go ahead, Matt.
I missed out. So, but I'm kind of like Sean. I didn't ask for enough. Apparently,
mine's a 10-night Norwegian fjord cruise to Iceland on Disney Cruise Line for $14,000.
Okay. Yeah. So, I can take about. Let's see. I can have about 28 different registrations to the Dobie Challenge for Scott's. That's all I was wanting, was just to get to do Dobie, and I guess I can do it 28 times if we're going on Scott's budget now.
Nice. Wow.
So how much is it? It's $550?
$560.
$560. Jeez.
Yeah.
Wow.
Man, no wonder why they call it the Dobie Challenge, because you're dopey to be spending that kind of money on it.
But you get 4 free t-shirts and then 4 free medals when you finish.
And a lot of Oreos and nacho cheese.
Exactly. And it'll probably have Baby Bell in there now for this race.
Nacho cheese.
Do they throw in emergency room too, or is that extra?
If you want to stop at one of those tents they have along the side, then it's free.
Free oxygen tanks.
Yeah,
they
really.
They might give you the free ride to the hospital. But
oh, okay.
Yeah, so everybody out there, you tell us who you think deserves to have their presence under the tree.
I didn't even finish yet.
Oh. But everybody out there, you tell us who you think deserves to have the presence. And does Scott really deserve to have that? It's really the question is Scott asking for too much from Santa? Okay, Keith.
Okay, thanks, because, you know, I'm still here and stuff. I had 2 annual passes. But I either had that, or at Launch Bay, they actually have this life-size Darth Vader bust that is really, really sweet looking. It's like $1,100. So apparently I can have a whole army's worth of Darth Vader bust for what Scott is paying for his.
Well, you just have to get the life-size Stormtrooper and like all the other ones they have there in that shop.
Yeah. I'll rent their Stormtroopers for like a day and just go and terrorize people like in shopping malls and stuff. That sounds fun too.
See, I would get in lots of trouble with that because my son's got one of the First Order Stormtroopers. It stands, I don't know, maybe about waist high to me, so it's, I don't know, a couple feet. Yes, if it's 6 feet tall and it comes up my waist.
Wow.
Tank, that one.
Yeah,
but I will randomly like stick it around the house and have it pointing its gun, so that when they walk in the door, Stormtroopers holding them up. It scares the ever living crap out of them.
That's awesome.
What a good daddy you are.
I try, you know.
It's the Stormtrooper on a shelf.
I've thought about doing it when he wakes up, where it's like standing right beside his bed, but I haven't done that yet.
Oh, you got to do it.
Please do and record it.
Yeah, exactly. All right. I think that's it for my Christmas list, everybody else's Christmas list. I don't know. Anything else to say, anybody?
Yeah, I feel cheap now.
Yeah, you're a cheap date.
I mean, after Scott, you know, has went and spent like a whole like village's worth of children's toys on his. Yeah. Man, I should have really spent some more time on this episode.
Yeah, I think so.
You're shoveling too much snow there.
Yeah, I was. I had
to catch myself. Almost said the wrong thing there.
Good catch.
All right, so that's going to do it for this week. First, we want to thank our sponsors, Kingdom Strollers. Get your premium stroller and crib rental at kingdomstrollers.com. Want to decorate those boring magic bands? Check out the customized decals at myfantasybands.com. Make sure you use the code EnchantedTikiTalk20 to save 20% off your order. Let the vacation experts at mousepros.com help plan your next perfect Disney vacation. Get a clear view of the parts with Woody's polarized sunglasses. Check out all their wood frame styles at woodys.com. Don't forget to check out our store at redbubble.com/tiki talk podcast. And you can always connect with us on social media. Find us on Facebook at Enchanted Tiki Talk, Instagram and Twitter at Tiki Talk Podcast, and leave us a message on the Tiki Talk hotline, which is 256-49-TIKI, 256-469-8454. And if you enjoy the show, please rate us on iTunes.
And you can find me on Twitter. I can't ever do this right. You can find me on Twitter at 1 Minute Disney Dream. That's 1 MIN Disney Dream. MouseWorldVacations.com and MousePros.com.
And you can find me on Twitter and Instagram at Dole Whip Daily.
And you can find me on Twitter at Scott A. Campbell or on Instagram at Scotty Boy.
I'm on Instagram and Twitter at mholly579. And with all that being said, Merry Christmas, everyone. Alan, buddy, we miss you. Thanks for bringing us all together. And keep an eye over all of us.
Thanks for listening this week. For Sean and Keith and Matt, I'm Alan. And this has been Enchanted Tiki Talk. Aloha.
Ho, ho, holy crap! Scott Campbell wants what?
That's the island greeting that send we send to you, you guys from the land where palm trees sway.
Thanks for listening this week. For Sean and Keith, I'm Alan. I am trying to close the show here, people.
Do 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 do.
Jitter's full.
Thanks for listening this week. For Sean and Keith, I can't do this. Thanks for listening this week. For Sean and Keith, I'm Alan, and this has been Enchanted Tiki Talk. Mele, Kaliki, Maka, and Aloha.
I am leaving that whole thing in.
Even shitters full?
Oh, yeah, it's staying in.
But what's going to be the outtake?
Well, we don't need one. That is the outtake. That's a live
We always
one.
Have an outtake, though. Got to do something at the end.
Mele kaliki maka is the thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Mele kaliki maka is the wise way to say Merry Christmas to you.
Mele kaliki maka is the thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Mele kaliki maka is Hawaii's way to say Merry Christmas to you. Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night.
Mele kaliki maka is a wise way
to say Merry Christmas to you. Mele kaliki maka is a thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway.
Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright.
The sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Melikalikimaka is a wise way to say Merry Christmas.
A very Merry Christmas.
A very, very Merry, Merry Christmas to you.
Oh, Wicked Booger King, make it fudge and whoppers, wear paper hat. Would you like an apple pie with that? Would you like an apple pie with that? Where is the bell? Wait for the bell. Where is the bell? Wait for the bell. Can't hear the bell. Wait for the bell. Where is the bell? Where is the bell? I woke up Burger King making fries and whoppers with a paper hat. Would you like an apple pie with that? Would you like an apple pie with that? Ding, fries are done. 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 I woke up Burger King making fries and whoppers with a paper hat. Would you like an apple pie with that? Would you like an apple pie with that? Ding, fries are done. Ding, fries are done. Ding, fries are done.
Enchanted Tiki Talk has been brought to you by MousePros.com. Let us plan your perfect Disney vacation. And MickeyMonthly.com, where you can get the park sent directly to you. And by KingdomStrollers.com for all your premium stroller and crib rental needs. Also by Trader Sam's Coffee. Why not brew some magic in your home? And finally, Woody's.com. Sunglasses for a glare-free view of the magic. For all of us here, I'm David Benter. Thanks for listening to Enchanted Tiki Talk.